have Dave on the phone. Dave, welcome to WPFW.
Thanks, Rusty. Great to hear talk
yeah,
to you.
Good to hear your voice again. Yes, indeed. It's been a while since we've had a conversation, but Groove Street is really grooving. It's really a fantastic album. How's it doing in terms of getting the word out about your music?
Oh, it's been great. People have really responded to this one nicely. In fact, it went up to number one on the Jazz Week radio and been still up there on the charts, in the top 10, you know, for weeks now. So that means a lot of people are hearing it. It's the working trio with Jared Gold on organ and McClinney Hunter on drums that I've had for about the last 15 years. And
yeah,
we had our buddy Bob Mitzer join us. And
he really added. It's really fantastic. Fantastic ensemble there. And so you're coming up to Keystone Corner up in Baltimore this weekend with another addition to your group. who's your guest artist?
Yeah, we got Warren Wolf again. Warren is one of our favorite guys to have join the show, and he'll be there. We'll be there Saturday and Sunday. Start at 6 and then 8:30, and Sunday 5 and 7:30.
Fantastic. No, Todd Bark has been doing a great job with the music up at Keystone Corner. Looking at his history with the music, going back to what he had in San Francisco a few decades ago.
Yep.
And I guess that was a little bit before your time getting started, but you've been doing a lot of music. How did you get into playing the guitar initially?
Well, I'm originally from Omaha, and I started early playing Beatles and rock music. Started listening to Wes Montgomery and George Benson.
Sure.
And once I got into that, it was over.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I remember catching you with Stanley Turrentine at Blues Alley more than a few years ago. That was quite a connection. Working with him, I'm sure, really got you out there.
Man, I was just talking to somebody else about that earlier tonight. How grateful I am that I got almost 10 years playing in Stanley's group all over the world and getting to hear him night after night, you know, that soulfulness of Stanley. I think it went off a little bit. I hope it didn't.
Yeah, no, it must have been quite a trip traveling around the world with him, as popular as he was, and yet as, you know, authentically, artistically as he was also, you know, he really was important in the history of our music. And because of that popularity, he comes, you know, gets neglected sometimes, but absolutely, you know, we keep his music here going on WPFW. You've also been doing a lot of teaching. How'd you shift gears and balance your life doing all of that?
Well, I mostly spent my whole life as a player. You know, once I left Jack McDuff a couple of years in Stanley, then I, you know, kind of started doing more of my own stuff, having my own groups and recording and touring around with my own groups. And when I was younger, I went to a Jamie Ebersol workshop. He's a great jazz educator out of Louisville, Kentucky. Later on, he asked me to teach at his workshop, and after, you know, I had attended when I was a kid, and then 20 years later, I was teaching there, and he had just a lot of great, great players, and educators at his camp, and so I met a lot of, made a lot of connections there, and was asked to start teaching David Baker, to start teaching at I thought that was a crazy idea, you know, living in New Jersey, that I'm going to go out to it. But yeah, I've gone on almost 11 years now.
Wow, yes.
I go out there every other week, and it works out nice, man. I enjoy it, and I also teach at Rutgers up here in Jersey, as well as in Montclair State.
So, That's unbelievable. That's on top of touring and performing. That's yeah, fantastic.
I keep pretty busy. I'll tell you that, Rusty.
Yeah, that's for sure. So tell us again about the gig coming up this weekend at Keystone Corner.
We always have a ball, man. Such a great club, and Todd Barkin, like we said, he's a legend, man. He's been putting this music out here for so many years, and so it's just a great feeling in that club. And we'll be there this Saturday. We start at 6, early 6.
Okay.
And then on Sunday, we're going to play at 5, 7:30. So.
Okay, 5 and 7:30, right. If you put in KeystoneCornerBaltimore.com, you can get ticket information for the performance with Dave coming up this weekend. And we're going to continue with your Groove Street album. I got Infant Eyes queued up, so we'll hear some Wayne Shorter in this next set after we hear your version of his composition. Thanks for calling in, Dave, and I know folks will be really coming out for your gig at Keystone Corner. And say hi to Todd for me when you catch up with him. Tell him we had a conversation today.
I will do that. And once again, it's with Warren Wolf, great vibist, Jared Gold on organ, myself on guitar, and McClenny Hunt on drums. And we look forward to seeing all our friends up in the Baltimore area this week.
Fantastic. Dave Stryker,